So starting with your second chapter, name is circuit diagrams and panel wiring diagram. So we know measuring instruments like ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter. You have already learned about it and also about DC motors in your 11th. So we have to understand where they are used. I mean to say what to measure. Ammeter, like you can say ammeter is used to measure current. Voltmeter used to measure voltage. So we'll see how the connection is, where to connect it in circuit, whether to connect it in parallel or in series. So we are going to learn this in this first point. So ammeter is used to measure amount of current flowing through the circuit, and voltmeter is used to measure the voltage, and wattmeter is used to measure the power. So ammeter is always connected in series. And we'll learn why we connect ammeter always in series. So we know we use ammeter to measure current. So this is device with very low resistance. It has low resistance. If we connect it in parallel, so first understand that we connect ammeter in series. So we connect it in series, and why we don't connect it in parallel, because it has low resistance, it will draw more current and it will get damaged. So we connect it in series. Remember, ammeter is always connected in series. Voltmeter is always connected in parallel. So voltmeter is always connected in parallel. Resistance of voltmeter is high. Wattmeter is used to measure power. It has current coil and pressure coil. Current coil is always connected in series, and pressure coil is always connected in parallel, and similarly in energy meter. So here is a diagram. So this is ICDP switch. So we have learned in first chapter about symbols. So this is iron plate double pole switch. So this switch is used where single phase supply comes in the picture. So it has 250 volt 50 hertz AC supply. So this is ammeter, which is connected in series. So ammeter is always connected in series. This is voltmeter, which is connected in parallel. And this is a wattmeter and energy meter. So we learned it has two coils. First one is current coil and second one is pressure coil. So current coil is connected in series and pressure coil is connected in parallel. So you can see here. So this is current coil, which is connected in series. So ML is current coil. CC, this is current coil. CV, which is pressure coil, which is connected in parallel. So this PP is also pressure coil, which is of energy meter. So from this, what we have to understand or remember, ammeter is connected in series, voltmeter is connected in parallel, wattmeter has two coils, current coil and pressure coil. Similarly in energy meter, current coil is connected in series, pressure coil is connected in parallel. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. So moving further, starters. So your second chapter is about starter, DC motors with starter and switches. So in this chapter we'll see what is a starter and why we need to use starter. So I guess you have learned DC motors in your 11th standard. So we'll just learn here that what is starter and why we use the starter. So first we'll understand what is a DC motor. So basically motor means what we do, we convert electrical energy to mechanical work. So this is the motor work. So generator converts mechanical into electrical. mechanical into electrical. Okay, so this is about motor and this is about generator. So we'll start. If you want to know or if you want to learn how DC motor works, then please comment below. You want to understand the working of the DC motor. But in this your chapter, you have just theory about starters and why they are used and different types of starters. So we'll learn in this lecture what are the starters. If you want DC motor, to learn about DC motor or working principle, so you can comment. I'll make the next video about that. So why we use starter? Basically, we use starter to protect our DC motor from damage that can be caused by high current during the startup. That means whenever we start the DC motor, in starting period or while we start, at the start it will take high current. So this high current will damage our motor. That means damage our winding. So we have to limit that starting current. So you know, to limit the current we use resistance. Resistance is nothing but which opposes the flow of current. So what we have to do to limit this current, we have to use this variable resistance. So resistors oppose the current. So resistors are placed in series. So these are placed in series with armature. So you can see here these resistors are placed in series with armature. Armature and resistance are in series. So you can see in the diagram, this resistance and armature are in series by connecting it to starting arm. So where is the starting arm? This is the starting arm, and then connecting it to OLC, that is overload coil, and then to the supply. So how our circuit completes is by, this is the supply. From here supply will come, it will pass through OLC and then go, this is the starting arm. So this arm will get connected to this resistance and then the current will go through the armature, and this is the circuit completed. So why this is called 3-point starter? Because it has 3 points. These 3 points are line, field and armature. We'll further study about a 4-point starter also. So we'll understand the working, how it works. So as I said, we have to limit the starting current. So we use this resistance in series. These are series with armature. So how it works, this is the starting arm and the current will come from this overload coil and then through this starting, with the starting arm. And now we'll connect this to this stud. These are the brass studs. So if we connect this arm to this, this all resistance will be in our circuit. This will come in picture. So when we connect the motor or give the supply, so this will be resistance, this many resistance will come in picture, and then our current will go through this armature. So this many resistance came in picture. So now we'll move this forward. So this arm, starting arm, will connect here and this resistance will get neglected. Then we'll just move this handle from here to here or here. This will be last one. So this all resistance will get neglected and this arm will get attached to this resistance, to this last one. So all the resistance are removed slowly. This handle, by taking this handle forward, will remove all the resistance from our circuit. So at last all the resistance will get out of the circuit and supply, and all the supply, whatever we are giving the supply from here, this will be will get, all the supply will get to our motor. So now we'll see what is the principle or why we use NVC coil, NVC in our a starter. So NVC is no volt coil. So why we use this NVC? So no volt coil is used to hold this starting arm. So how it works, let's see. So you can see here our negative point is going through the field. So you can see our negative point is going through the field and then to the NVC, and NVC is connected to the resistance. You can see here, these are the resistance. We are connecting it to the resistance, and this is the circuit of NVC. So it gets into the circuit. So we know if this NVC circuit is completed, that means it will form magnet. So it will form magnet and it will act as a magnet and it will hold this. This is a soft iron piece. So it will hold this here till the where our last resistance is there. So it will, this handle will come here and it will hold here. This NVC coil will hold this handle here. So now we'll see what our OLC works for. OLC is overload coil. So we'll see OLC, what is the role of OLC here. So whenever the high current flows, then if the current, it has some particular limit, if the limit is crossed, if the current beyond limit flows through this coil, then this coil will act as magnet. OLC will make a magnet due to high current, and this lever, or this is called strip or lever, will get attached or attracted towards this. And so what will happen when this get attracted towards this OLC? These two terminals, or this two, you can see this is here is connection. When this strip moves upwards and get attracted towards this, then this will become short circuited. So there will be no current flowing through this, or this NVC will get demagnetized and leave this starting arm to its original position. So whenever our motor is okay, then this starting arm will be in this position, and whenever the current is high, then what this OLC will do, it will form magnet, and this strip will get attracted upwards, and this, because of this attraction here, NVC will get short circuited, and this NVC is demagnetized, and this will come here. So because of this demagnetization, the magnet here will get disappear, and this will leave this soft iron piece, and it will come here to the back. It will come here back. So basically this starter is used to limit the starting current. So what are the points that you have to remember is, why is the starter used? So why we use starter? To limit starting high current. So we use this starter to limit the starting high current. So how will remember this? Just remember, starter is used to limit the starting high current. So how the current is limited? It is limited by including the resistance. So here we have the resistance which are in series with the armature. So whenever we start our motor, this is the handle, we have to push the handle so that it will come across this all the resistance, and then it will start our motor at the given supply. So this is the working of the starter, 3-point starter. I will explain it again, so listen it carefully. Why starter is used? Starter is used to limit the starting current. Okay, so these are the resistance. So when we connect this starting arm to this resistance, this all resistance come in picture, and there will be low current flowing through the circuit when there are when we start the motor. So we'll just push this handle forward, so it will come here. This one resistance will get neglected. So our current increases slowly. So there will be no starting high current. So at last our this starting arm will come here. So how our circuit gets completed? Current will start flowing through this OLC, through this starting arm. Then starting arm will get connected to this resistance and then to our armature. So there are two points, OLC and NVC. If the current will flow beyond the limit, then this will attract, or this will become magnet, and this will attract this strip upwards. Due to this attraction, these two points will get short circuited and this our NVC will get demagnetized, and this will leave our starting arm and there will be no current flowing through it, or our motor will stop. So moving forward, 4-point starter. So 4-point starter, why we use? So we use a 4-point starter to overcome the disadvantages in 3-point starter. We use 4-point starter. So 4-point starter, starting with 4-point starter. So why it is called 4-point starter? Because it has 4 points, L, F, A, and this is here N. So there are 4 points here in this 4-point starter. So we say it or call it 4-point starter. So why we use 4-point starter? So 4-point starter is actually used to overcome the disadvantages in 3-point starter. We use 4-point starter. What are the disadvantages in 3-point starter? If you want to increase the speed of motor, if you want to increase the speed of motor in 3-point starter, we cannot increase the speed of motor. So we know N is equal to Eb upon phi. So if you want to increase the speed, we need to decrease the flux. So, or we need to decrease the flux, it means we need to reduce the current to the field winding. But in 3-point starter, if we reduce the current through the field winding, then what will happen? NVC will not hold the handle. I'm right. So it will come to this position. If the current is low, then this will not become magnet and it will attract this upwards. So there will be no magnet form and this will come to the this position. So we cannot directly directly reduce the current through the field winding. So here you can see, here field is given separately. So field is given separately and now we can reduce the current. So this is the disadvantage that has overcome in 4-point starter. So the working here is same as 3-point starter, but the difference is to overcome the disadvantages in 3-point starter, we use 4-point starter. So if we want to reduce the current in the field winding, we cannot directly reduce. Why? Because NVC will not hold our handle here. So we cannot directly reduce the current in field winding. So here in 4-point starter, we have given the separate field is given here. So I hope you have understood this. If you have any doubts, you can comment below. I'll try to cover it in next video.